seems like a busy Monday morning here in Gray Shopping Centre. You've called this a summit. Why have you called the summit?
I thought it was really important that Grays makes the most of the opportunity to bid for this money. It's not an enormous amount of money, so we shouldn't think that it's going to transform the shopping centre overnight and the town centre overnight. But Grays has got some really unique opportunities. It's a place where independent retailers thrive. Last week there was a national survey that indicated for the first time that the number of independent retailers on our high street is going up. Again, it tells us that what happens in Thurrock, in England, happens in Thurrock first, because we've already got that. That is something we don't have empty shop fronts, because people here are determined to make money. Well, because we think about the fact that we've got Lakeside, we are already a retailing community, but people are doing something really quite amazing, which is making money despite Lakeside being there. And what we want to be able to do is to say to Mary Portas and the government, look at how we're doing here, and help us, with a little bit of money, to make more of our already great strength, which is our independent retailers, our market, and the determination of people here in Grays to be able to make some money even when times are tough. So those are the reasons why I did it, and it was actually extremely useful to be able to get people together, both from big chains like Specsavers and Boots, and small organisations and small retailers who are managing to continue to make money in Grays. That's why we're here.
And what feedback have you got from the other retailers here this morning?
Well, what the retailers told me was that in comparison to other places, Grays is actually doing quite well. And we kind of have to remember that, because there's often a tendency to say, oh, well, we can't survive because of Lakeside and so forth. And actually, things are actually doing quite well. There are some big challenges that people wrote. Parking and the way traffic works were clearly issues for people. And also issues to do with antisocial behaviour. There's no doubt about it, when the elderly or young mums with kids are coming into town, they want to feel confident that they're going to be safe. Now those aren't things that an amount of money of being a Portas town pilot might necessarily make a difference about. But they're very important for politicians like me and for the council to hear yet again. When it comes to it, if we're talking about making sure that Grays is a thriving town centre in the future, we take into account those things are still big challenges for people.